Hello, 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 and welcome to myfinanceteacher.org. Again, talking about gold and crude oil today, some interesting developments in both of those markets. Before we continue, let me remind you guys to subscribe to the channel if you haven't, and click that bell notification. Thanks a lot. And we're going to start with gold. After a nice rally in gold in the beginning of the ongoing intermediate cycle, between mid-November and January, we've seen gold take a rest a little bit over the last month or so, and what has formed on the chart is some kind of a triangle consolidation area. It looks like it's more or less a symmetrical triangle, so a break out of the triangle is equally likely on the up as well as on the downside. As I mentioned in previous videos, since the intermediate cycle is not very mature yet, we were expecting gold prices to continue higher. And it looks like yesterday on Friday, gold broke out on the upside from this triangle. Over the last month, this 50-day moving average caught up a little bit with the gold price. So I think there is some nice potential in gold to push higher over the next few weeks, possibly into that 1625 target that we mentioned earlier, which is based on this longer term view and the nearest resistance level, according to December 2012 lows. So 1625 is going to be 2.5% gain from current levels on gold price. But of course, if you've been following me over the last few months, you probably had a chance to get into this trade at much lower levels, somewhere below 1500. Another positive thing on gold is comparing this consolidation triangle with what happened in the previous advancing phase of the intermediate cycle. There as well, we saw a quick rise between late April and mid-June. And after a quick rise, gold again took a little bit of a rest, which also turned out to be more or less a symmetrical triangle over here from mid-June to late July. Once gold broke out on the upside from the previous triangle, it rose nearly as much as in May-June rise in dollar terms rather than percentage terms. In May-June, we saw about $150 rally in gold. And in July-September, we also saw nearly $150 rally in gold again. So if history repeats, which is not a guarantee, of course, we might even easily break through that resistance of 1625, in which case gold will probably reach the next resistance level somewhere close to that round number of 1650. So as I mentioned in previous videos, I'm still positive. Personally, I'm still holding GLD, GDX, some of the particular miners that I'm also interested in. But there is also a cautionary tale. This is GDX, and it's not really performing well during this intermediate cycle. In the previous intermediate cycle, it outperformed the gold itself, giving us a rally of over 50%, nearly 54%. But since November, the rally hasn't been so strong, and GDX is still kind of stuck within this consolidation triangle. Over the last couple of weeks, volatility has been quite low on GDX, and especially over the last week or two, it's been chugging just along this 50-day moving average. So gold miners so far are not confirming this strength in gold, which means you've got to be careful and probably keep your stop losses somewhere tight enough so that you don't lose too much in case there is volatility on the downside. And there should be some volatility. As I mentioned in some of my older videos, periods of low volatility are replaced with periods of high volatility. And I think there is a slightly higher chance that volatility in GDX is going to be to the upside, since gold itself so far looks promising. Maybe you guys can tell me something interesting in regards to gold, silver, or miners. Let me know what you think in the comments below. What's the prospect for precious metals over the next couple of months? I'd be really interested in your opinion. Next, let's move on to crude oil. It's doing well. We bounced off this deeply oversold level on RSI. Plus, crude oil was due for an intermediate cycle low, which usually happens every half a year or so. At the recent lows in early February, crude oil was a whole 15% below its 200-day moving average, and even after the bounce, it's still 8% below 200-day moving average. So over the next few weeks, even if we just retest that 200-day moving average and turn back down, that's an 8% gain. But I think there is a nice chance to retest low 60s, as I mentioned in my previous video. And looking at one last indicator for crude oil, which is also promising nice gains, this is market sentiment indicator. We see that a few days ago, traders were really, really scared about crude oil. And of course, as a contrarian, you want to buy when there is blood on the streets. Something similar happened here at the end of 2018, early 2019. And that level of blood on the streets, that level of market pessimism, forecasted a very nice gains into mid-2019. So I think crude oil is at least as interesting or even more interesting than gold at the moment. And I'm personally holding a nice position in USO as well as a couple of interesting producers. And that's all for now. Have a nice weekend. Keep safe and good luck in your trades.